Mufisi hayuko hapa. Muhaina, that is. My name is Kabeeria. Very excited to be able just to introduce myself, introduce a bit of the work that we are really involved in. And I want all the hyenas to take a seat. Mafisi wote, take a moment. I need you to slow down. I want to share a bit of a heart-to-heart around issue ya abortion. Number one, Kenya dunia inasema, what is our culture saying about this issue? Then number two, we're going to touch on what the scripture also has to say about this very, very sensitive topic. So number one, many people will argue off the bat, wanasemanga, my body, in fact, my dress, my choice. Nyuma ya hiyo, my body, it's my right to do with my body whatever I want to do with my body. Hey, madem kwanza unaweza tiktika hapo chini kama hiyo ndio ukweli yako. Sa, tukisema, it's the right of a woman to procure an abortion. And many of our friends in this pande ya SRHR watasema, ni haki yetu, ni haki yetu. Sisi ndio tunaamua venye tutafanya na mili yetu. Now, my mind is this. Wouldn't it be better if we begin to deconstruct? Yani, tunatuanisha ni nini inaeleza iyo notion ya kwamba itasema? Abortion, by the way, ni option safi. In fact, abortion ndio rada safi ile. That's the way to go. I want to question that. And I want to suggest this. Reality yenye tunaishi nayo leo sio mpya. Abortion did not start today. Actually, in our culture. Kwanza mi kwenye natoka. Kwenye mi natoka, the other side of Mount Kenya. Ungepatikana na hiyo story. Wacha safe abortion. Ilikuwa inaundaundwa ikiwa ndani yako. So that you are forced to miscarry. Juu umefanya nini? Umeleta shame kwa wasi. Umeleta shame kwa family, kwa jamii, kwa community. So reality inakuwa, your story haiku change. Take it back 1,000 years. Enzi za Warumi. In fact, tashanga. Warumi walikuwa yasema, you know what? Juu sahi nimepachika mimba, maze it affect quality of life yangu, it affect mentality yangu, ata my whole reality is just going to be messed up. Unaona, sita kuwa na time ya kuhang out, kuhang na mabeste, kujipa, kujirusha, because umepata nini? You're born. So, it began to be accessible for many. In fact, it was common to have abortions. That is in the first century. Time, yenye maandiko inatuambia, a man called Christ appeared on the scene. Now Christ alikuwa na kitu moja in mind, to preserve life. Ata preserve life kiasi ya kwamba, he'll give his own life so that we learn how to preserve life. Some centuries before that, his great-great ancestor, David himself, aliandika kwa Psalms 139. Asemanga, I was fearfully and wonderfully made. In my mother's womb, you put me together. Anasema, God, hii ujuzi yenye umeniumba nayo, it's too much for me. How massive are your thoughts towards me? God anasema, the very process ya kucreate a child ako kati. The very process, knitting together, splicing the DNA, putting together, even Ecclesiastes in Asamanga, do you know which way the spirit enters into the framing of bones inside the womb? Jewajua, God is involved in conception, in forming the baby, that bones and the skull and cells would develop and differentiate. In fact, there's a really, really wonderful thing that happens even just to decide why a child will be male or female. And all that chemistry na happen, Psalms inasema, God akiendesha. Then, wume pachika yo ball, unasema yo ni laana, unasema yo kitu ita mess life yako utawawa na mzazi. Na God anasema, fearfully and wonderfully he's making us. The complexity of the human body. Kwanza inafai itufanye, we just stand in awe of one another. So the heart of this challenge, nyi mnasema it's your right. Do you know why it is your right? Because your body, you're the temple not only of God, you are made in the very image of God. That is why your personal dignity, your personal right to life, izo swali zote zinakuwa na weight. Why? juu tukisema tutaabort maumbo ama na mapanya tunazifanya testing, tunazikatakata, hakuna mtu ananipeleka jela, mi nafanya science. But nikichukua wasee nianze kuwakatakata, man, the last. Question is this, my friends in the SRHR camp, they are suggesting the only solution is that we make abortion accessible. It has to be a human right. I believe it is not a human right to destroy human life. We need to rethink this strategy. Na tukichunguza vizuri, you'll discover something else. The reason why abortion has grown so popular came about after the sexual revolution. And the intention ilikuwa kitu moja, kama mjui, inaitwa eugenics. Eugenics is the reducing of human population strategically and systematically. Unaona story yenye Hitler alifanyanga? Nothing very different. We want to reduce certain demographics more. That's why utapata mali inaitwa Africa is the new frontier of making sure abortion is available. In fact, the abortion related deaths on the continent are the highest the whole world. So, suggestion mino wapea. Dwini hivi, chunguza. Explore what is this human anatomy. Na ya pili, ninge suggest very heavily the dignity yenye uyo mtoi yako nayo. Ada wewe sahi mwenye unafikiria hii neza hape neza flashy ball. The dignity uyo mtoi yako nayo ni high juu ya kitu moja. Ni high juu Christ alichukua mwili kama yako. Kama yangu. God could have chosen to be anything. To be anyhow. But because of the dignity that men carry in his image, he chose to become a human being. And he gave a new dignity to the human body by accepting to be carried to term. Hata uziake kwa hiyo position. Juu watu wengi wanasahau hiyo story. We almost at Christmas time, watu wengi usahau hiyo story. Mary herself was very likely in her teenage years when the Holy Spirit comes upon her. Joseph alikuwa alikuwa ametegea, alikuwa amesema baby hapa ndalipa hiyo mahari itakuwa safi. In fact, they were already committed. There was a betrothal already in place. That means she was waiting for this guy to come and say, by the way, kwenye nakupeleka kuko fiti, tuende. Kurudi, story imeche. Na Joseph pia alikuwa mwanaume. Nawaambia, kweni hawa wanaume. Please hear from heaven. Value life. Yes, umemdunga hiyo ball. Unampea doo ya kuflash. Nisiwe umempea doo ya kutunza hiyo life. Na hiyo ndio part ya purpose why God has made us male and female. Mary survived. My sister, you'll survive. My bro, hold her hand and give her the encouragement that you can make it through the other side.